So, hello, Japan-less readers, watchers, whatever. Anyway, fans of Japanese history. One of the things I like to say is that there's a lot of Edo still existing in Tokyo. You just need to know where to look and what you're looking at. One of the other things that is really helpful is learning how to read the topography of the city, like the elevation, like where is the high ground, where is the low ground. So I've always talked about the differences between Yamanote, the high city, and Shitamachi, the low city, the commoner districts. And one of the books that really opened my mind to that entire concept and actually changed the way that I look at the city today is it a book I have here by Jinai Hidenobu called Tokyo, A Spatial Anthropology. There is a Japanese version. It's much cheaper. I bought this for my wife and I'm pretty sure she never read it. Anywho, this book is amazing, and I can't recommend it enough. So without further ado, we'll get into the main video. So today I went down to Shinagawa, and Shinagawa Station is located at the old coastline of Edo Bay. On the west side of the train tracks of the station, you have a hilly area where it was kind of countryside or a suburb, and there were some daimyo in the area. We'll get into that later. But on the east side of the station, there are no hills. There's nothing. It's completely flat. And the reason it's completely flat is because that was Tokyo Bay, well, Edo Bay, until the 1950s when they sort of reclaimed all of that area and the shoreline. It's even difficult to use the word shoreline today, but the water has been pushed quite a far distance out. But the difference in the topography is striking. I mean, it's night and day. It's a little bit difficult to see today because there are a lot of buildings, especially on the west side, but I think in the video that I shot, you'll be able to see this difference. And when you come to Tokyo, or if you're already in Tokyo, when you walk around, maybe you'll have a little easier time trying to read the city and identify Yamanote traits and Shitamachi traits and whatnot. Anyways, let's take a look at the video. So here we are looking at the west side of the train tracks between Tamachi Station and Shinagawa Station. Of course, the busy road in front of me is flat and that's no coincidence, but immediately on the other side of the street you can see some trees and it's very clear that there are hills. In the Edo period, this area was heavily wooded, and it still preserves a certain amount of greenery, which is characteristic of the Yamanote, the old high city. Looking over here, we can see Tokyo Tower in the distance. Tokyo Tower stands on one of the highest hills in the city, but from this perspective, you can see that the other hills and the buildings on those hills make a clear view impossible. And here's a shrine. So there are tons of shrines and temples along the old shoreline. Now, this isn't because it was the shoreline, but because this was part of the old Tokaido Highway that connected Edo and Kyoto. So the constant traffic was big business for temples and shrines. But again, note the abundance of greenery and the stairs going up the slopes. And here we have a hill reinforced by concrete to prevent erosion. But in terms of topography, it's pretty clear that there were many steep slopes in the area. This area in general is called Takanawa, and it includes the kanji for takai, which means high or elevated in Japanese. Again, here you can see the lush greenery and the elevation, and all of those trees go all the way up the hill. Okay, so now let's go to the west side of the train tracks. So here, everything is flat. If you've ever gone to the beach, you've seen how flat and gradual the gradations from the mainland into the sea is. But in the 1950s, Tokyo just leveled out that land. They removed the gradations until they had reclaimed all the land and just pushed the coastline further and further out. No hills, right? No hills. I just want to point out here, you can see two whale tails that mark the shopping street. So whaling and fishing were huge in this area, and even though the sea is not there today, you can see there's a close-up of the whale tail, or maybe it's a fish. And here you can clearly see the hills in the background and the original coastline, but when the sea was still there. Now, with this shot, I think you can much more dramatically see how flat the topography is. Sure, there are skyscrapers, but you can't see a single hill. You are looking at Edo Bay right now. A person from the Edo period probably couldn't even begin to imagine all of this, and the fishermen who lived their livelihoods here must be spinning in their graves. Lastly, a little bonus that I didn't plan to include, but hey, why the hell not? This is the Takanawa Okido. It was originally a checkpoint that gave you entry to the city of Edo. It was only used for a short time, but it was an important symbol in art and in the imagination of travelers. So once you reached the Okido, you were in the shogun's capital, the most vibrant city in all of Japan. So most people don't even notice this today, it's just on the side of this busy street, but it's still marking a border of some kind. So I love the stonework, they have those gargantuan stones on the corners and the small ones in the middle, and note the grass growing on top of the stone walls, because that's been the case since the Edo period. And finally, here in this ukiyo-e print, you can see the grass growing on top of the Okido, and you can see Edo Bay. I guess this is a nice way to wrap up all of the video. So there we are. Thank you for watching to the very end. I really appreciate it. I'd like you to support this channel, so please follow my channel if you wanna. Follow me on Twitter, follow me on Facebook, follow me on Flickr, follow me everywhere. All that information is going to be linked down below. If you are in Tokyo or you're in Japan and you need a tour guide or a fixer or anything like that, especially if it's history oriented, I'm your guy. You can contact me via YouTube or Facebook or pretty much anyway. Twitter is pretty good. Please consider becoming a patron of the blog. You can do that on Patreon, or you can do that via PayPal, or just share, give it a like, anything like that. Like, I'm cool with that too. But hopefully you come to Tokyo. Let's hook it up. Aw yeah.